हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वंस अगेन वेलकम बैक इन माय यूट्यूब चैनल। दोस्तों, आज का जो वीडियो, इस वीडियो में हम लोग बात करने वाले हैं अबाउट स्ट्रक्चर इंजीनियरिंग जॉब। किस तरह से स्ट्रक्चर इंजीनियरिंग की जॉब पाएं, हर किसी की यही कोशिश होती है कि हाउ टू गेट अ स्ट्रक्चर इंजीनियरिंग जॉब। बट व्हाट डू यू द कर्मा, व्हाट आर द इम्पोर्टेंट कर्मा फॉर गेटिंग द स्ट्रक्चर इंजीनियरिंग जॉब, इसके बारे में हम लोग इस वीडियो में देखेंगे। इस वीडियो को अगर आपको अच्छा लगेगा तो लाइक करके जाइएगा और शेयर करके जाइएगा, और उसके बाद सब्सक्राइब तो करेंगे ही करेंगे अगर हमने अभी हो तो। दोस्तों, सबसे पहले मैं बात करूं तो आपका स्ट्रक्चर इंजीनियरिंग की जॉब के लिए क्या क्या चीज़ें चाहिए, पहले उन पर डिस्कस कर लेते हैं। तो सबसे पहले आपको ये पता होना चाहिए कि हमको पढ़ना क्या है स्ट्रक्चर इंजीनियरिंग की जॉब के लिए। तो ऑलरेडी मैंने दो वीडियो बनाया हुआ है कि क्या क्या टॉपिक हैं जो इम्पोर्टेंट है स्ट्रक्चर इंजीनियरिंग की जॉब लेने के लिए। उसके बाद अगर बात करें टॉपिक के अलावा तो और हमें क्या करना चाहिए, हमें जो जिसके वजह से हमें अच्छी जॉब मिल सके। तो सबसे पहला चीज़ है, आप कंपनी की जॉब डिस्क्रिप्शन देखो। दोस्तों, आप कंपनी की जॉब डिस्क्रिप्शन नहीं देखते हो, जेडी जी बोलते हैं उसको, जेडी मतलब क्या होता है, जॉब डिस्क्रिप्शन। अगर वो नहीं देख रहे हो आप, तो आपको कैसे पता चलेगा उस कंपनी को क्या चाहिए, ठीक है। तो अगर आपको स्टडी करना है तो आप स्टडी करो, आप जाते हो कंपनी, मान लो कई लोगों के शॉर्टलिस्टिंग भी मैंने देखा हो जाती है, बट कंपनी में गए और गए तो उनका सिलेक्शन नहीं हुआ, बोलते वहाँ पर सर ये पूछ लिए। आपको पता है क्या, अगर आपने ध्यान से उस जॉब डिस्क्रिप्शन को पढ़ा होता तो सारे क्वेश्चन जो बनते हैं उसी के सराउंड्स बनते हैं। क्यों? क्योंकि अगर मुझे कुक चाहिए, अगर सोचो मुझे कुक चाहिए, और कुक के लिए मुझे क्या चाहिए, कुक को आना चाहिए क्या, सब्जी बनाना, रोटी बनाना, और जो भी आप खाते हो, मैं यही खाता हूँ, तो आपको क्या चाहिए, जो खाते हो उसी से रिलेटेड पूछोगे ना। अब मैं उसे पूछूँ कि पिज्ज़ा कैसे बनाते हैं, बेवकूफ़ हूँ ना मैं, क्योंकि मैं खुद नहीं खाता पिज्ज़ा, ठीक है। तो कभी भी इस तरह के क्वेश्चन मत पूछो जो हम लोग नहीं करते हैं, ठीक है। तो इसको भी आपको ध्यान रखना है कि हम लोग जो कंपनी होती है, कंपनी अपने काम से रिलेटेड वर्क ही पूछती है, मतलब कि जॉब डिस्क्रिप्शन जो है उसके सराउंड ही पूछती है। अगर उनकी रिक्वायरमेंट है कि बंदा मैनुअल डिज़ाइन जाने, तो आपसे पक्का है, प्रॉमिस करेंगे, प्रॉमिस कर सकता हूँ कि आपसे वही क्वेश्चन पूछेंगे कि मैनुअल डिज़ाइन कैसे करते हैं। अगर वो कंपनी अमेरिका की एक लाइक अमेरिकन टॉपिक्स ले रही है, मींस अगर वो अमेरिका से प्रोजेक्ट ले रही है या ब्रिटिश से प्रोजेक्ट ले रही है, भाई आप इंडियन स्टैंडर्ड क्यों पढ़ के जा रहे हो? क्यों? क्योंकि वो तो अमेरिकन स्टैंडर्ड पूछने वाले हैं, ब्रिटिश स्टैंडर्ड पूछने वाले हैं। हो सकता है कंपनी यहाँ का भी काम कर रही हो, तो आपको तीनों कोड पढ़ के जाना पड़ेगा मेरे भाई, ठीक है। मींस आपको क्या क्या पढ़ के जाना है, अमेरिकन कोड पढ़ के जाना है, ब्रिटिश कोड पढ़ के जाना है, और इंडियन कोड पढ़ के जाना है। क्यों पढ़ के जाना है? अरे, आपने गए थे जब आप वेबसाइट पे अप्लाई कर रहे थे, तो वेबसाइट पे आपने जाके उसके सर्विसेज पे देखा कि वो लोग फॉरेन के प्रोजेक्ट कर रहे हैं, तो यार जब फॉरेन के प्रोजेक्ट कर रहे हैं तो आपको ही तो पूछेंगे ना उस प्रोजेक्ट के लिए, तो आपसे क्या क्वेश्चन पूछेंगे, उस फॉरेन के जो प्रोजेक्ट्स हैं उनसे रिलेटेड क्वेश्चन पूछेंगे। तो आपको क्या करना चाहिए, उससे रिलेटेड आपको क्वेश्चंस पढ़ के जाने चाहिए। बहुत से फॉरेन के लाइक मैंने देखे हैं प्रोफेसर जो यूट्यूब पे ऑलरेडी कई आरसीसी के वीडियोस डाले हुए हैं, उनके देखिए कैसे लोग डिज़ाइन करते हैं, क्या क्या वो लोग फॉर्मूले यूज़ करते हैं, उनको देखिए। मैं अगर इंडियन कोड देखना है तो मेरे भी चैनल पर काफ़ी वीडियोज़ पड़े हुए हैं, और लाइक आपको और वीडियोज़ चाहिए तो आप नीचे कमेंट कर देना, मैं उनके बारे में बताऊँगा। मीन्स कुल मिला के मेरे कहने का मतलब ये है दोस्तों कि जॉब डिस्क्रिप्शन को अच्छे से पढ़ के जाओ, और तैयारी करना है तो उसी से रिलेटेड तैयारी करो। आपने बोला सर एक कंपनी के लिए तैयारी करता हूँ, दूसरे के लिए रिक्वायरमेंट आती है, फिर तीसरे के लिए रिक्वायरमेंट आती है, मीन्स जिसके लिए तैयारी कर रहा था वो तो आया नहीं। हाँ जी, आपको जॉब डिस्क्रिप्शन सिर्फ एक कंपनी की नहीं, आप naukri.com चलाते हो या इंडीड चलाते हो, वहाँ पे देखिए कि स्ट्रक्चर इंजीनियर की जॉब डिस्क्रिप्शन होती क्या क्या है। तो उनकी जॉब डिस्क्रिप्शन की आप एक वर्ड फाइल, एक्सेल फाइल बनवा लीजिए, जिसमें बनाने में आपको कंफर्टेबल हो बना लीजिए। उनमें एक एक पे मीन्स अगर आप तीन चार जॉब के जॉब डिस्क्रिप्शन निकाल लेंगे तो मुश्किल से आपके 20 से 25 पॉइंट्स बनेंगे जिनको आपको तैयार करना पड़ेगा। अगर मैं पॉइंट्स की बात करूँ तो क्या क्या पॉइंट्स हो सकते हैं कि स्ट्रक्चर इंजीनियर के लिए, पहला पॉइंट हो सकता है मैनुअल डिजाइन ऑफ बीम कॉलम फुटिंग स्लैब, ओके। इसके बाद हो सकता है आपसे पूछ ले क्या सीयर वॉल के बारे में। इसके बाद उनका जॉब डिस्क्रिप्शन क्या होगा कि पीपल मस्ट बी नो अबाउट बीबीएस, आप बीबीएस के बारे में अच्छे से पढ़ लो। पीपल मस्ट बी नो द लाइक बीओक्यू बिल ऑफ क्वांटिटी के बारे में पढ़ लीजिए। शुड हैव गुड नॉलेज ऑफ व्हाट, गुड नॉलेज ऑफ ACI कोड्स, ब्रिटिश कोड, इंडियन कोड, जो भी होगा। पीपल शुड नो द सॉफ्टवेयर लाइक ऑटोकैड और माइट बी दिस इज फॉर स्ट्रक्चर इंजीनियर, सो दे कैन आस्क द स्टैट प्रो एंड ई टैप्स ऑल्सो, ओके। सो दे कैन डेफिनेटली गोइंग टू आस्क द क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम ई टैप्स और स्टैट प्रो, वॉट दे आर गोइंग टू आस्क यू क्वेश्चन लाइक फॉर स्टैट प्रो दे आर डेफिनेटली गोइंग टू आस्क यू क्वेश्चन लाइक रन स्ट्रक्चर विजार्ड, वॉट इज द यूज ऑफ रन स्ट्रक्चर विजार्ड। इफ दे आस्क अबाउट लाइक ई टैप्स तो दे कैन आस्क वॉट इज द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ ई टैप्स, extended three-dimensional analysis building system. So try to prepare these questions like this. What is the use of mass forces? So everyone know mass forces is used for provide the scale factor in seismic analysis. Everyone know what is response spectrum analysis? Are yaar, this is the dynamic analysis. So they can ask the questions like what is the dynamic analysis. So you can prepare the questions related to dynamic analysis. What they can ask the question related to dynamic analysis? Time history analysis. They can ask pushover analysis. They can ask response spectrum analysis. So definitely they are going to ask question like this. If the company is working for high-rise building, they are going to ask you question related to wind analysis, related to seismic analysis. So try to prepare questions related to wind and seismic. How to design a manually, you can check this. And also you can check in which city you are. Suppose you are in Delhi. What is basic wind speed of Delhi? Try to check the what are the basic wind speeds in IS 875 part 3. Everything is available. You can go and read there. Okay, so whatever they are going to ask, definitely ask from job description. They are not going to ask from any other portions. So first of all, your first point is what? Try to prepare every job description, means try to prepare 3 or 4 job descriptions, and each lines you can do the works on each lines. Minimum if you give them 15 to 20 days, this is enough for preparing these things. Okay, now the second thing, what are the important second very important step is what? Your project. Definitely if you are going there in like in any job, they are going to ask you question from your project, whatever project you did in college. Just prepare everything about that projects. Might be they can ask what was your project, describe your projects in deep. You can like whatever terms are like they can ask from that, like suppose like your might be your project is related to fly ash. So they can ask the question like what is fly ash. They can ask the questions types of fly ash. There are two types, C type, F type. Where we like from where we can get C type, from where we can get F type. So they are definitely going to questions ask like this. And this is your second step. So definitely try to prepare first of all job description, and second is your whatever project you did in your college. So this is very important for you. And then third questions, they are what they are going to ask you about your technical skills. So what they can ask about your technical skills means what you did in your college, what you learned, which type of software you learned there. So suppose you learn there AutoCAD. So what you know about AutoCAD, try to know that in deep, because they are not going to ask you question what is the line or what is the shortcut key of line, because they know you know the line command. They are going to ask you questions what is the use of xref command. You can say x reference also. So what is the use of xref command? They are definitely going to ask like this. They can ask what is the use of construction line command, what is the use of purge command. So they are going to might be they can ask what is layer, what is difference between static block and dynamic block. So static block is what? Static block is like static block is what? Which block is fixed? That block is static block. Which block is not fixed means like you can ask like you can change their front view, top view, like so this is what? This is dynamic analysis, sorry, dynamic block. So definitely they are going to ask you question related to this. And sometimes they can ask like suppose you said I know very well stat pro. So they can ask in stat pro like what is the file format of stat pro. So definitely everyone know .std. So try to prepare this type when you convert your AutoCAD file in stat pro. So what is your file format for AutoCAD? .dxf, everyone know. But if you don't know these things, so try to know these things. So your this one is your third step. First one was what? First one you can prepare whatever job descriptions of there. And second thing is try to prepare your whole things about your projects. And one thing is guidance from my side. Suppose you are going for high-rise building structure company, okay, and your project is on hydraulic structure, that is not good yaar. So if you have a other project knowledge, so try to mention that project which is relevant with your high-rise building structure, because that persons who is going to take your interview, they definitely know about the building construction more. They don't know about hydraulic structure. So please try to prepare other projects, like you can mention, suppose you did the project how to clean like a rapid send filter and slow send filter was there in environmental science, but you can remove that project because that project was not that much valuable though. So friend, suppose you are going for geotech company, so try to mention any geotech related projects. Might be you can like use a plate like a plate test, there is SPT test, cone penetration test. Try to mention this type of test in your projects so that they feel yes, you did the projects relevant with this one. Okay, and this is very useful for MBA guys, but I'm not going to talk about MBA today because MBA is different sector. I'm talking about structure engineering, so we come here only. So these were your third steps, and fourth step is what, friends? Fourth step is your resume. What you are doing in resume, the first problem is what? Suppose you mention your name and then you mention your address. Suppose I'm from Allahabad, so I mention there Allahabad, and company is located in Mumbai. They are not going to shortlist your resume in Mumbai. You know why? Because they know if people guy will come from Allahabad in Mumbai, that's not good for their company, because definitely you want a holiday after two or three months. They don't like to you take more and more holidays. So first of all, work on that holiday. So definitely if the company like want the people who living in Mumbai, so you can just mention your resume, like in resume your address is Mumbai. Which one? Permanent address you can change whatever your permanent address, but short address you can change everyone know Mumbai location, so change the Mumbai location nearby, any locations, might be Thane or whatever locations are there, I don't know that much. Okay, so the first step is what? Change your locations. Okay, second step is change your career objectives. Sometimes whatever they are as they can whatever they just do the copy from Google and paste there. See the meaning of that career objective. If in that career objective mention there my growth and as well as company growth, definitely people like that things. But if you just like have my growth are my goals and all, if you mention like this career objective, they are not going to entertain you. Third thing, what you are doing, friends? Third thing is your degree. Maximum times I see the degrees, like you mention your degrees in which first of all they mention 10th, then 12th, then BTech, then MTech. This is wrong, man. First of all mention your MTech, then mention your BTech or BE, or then 12th, then 10th. So try to mention in rows. Okay, so decreasing order is good, not increasing order for degree mentions. Okay, and second thing, sometimes what they are doing, like BTech, just mention here what BTechs. Maximum time I see the guy like resume, they are mention their BTech. Which stream? No one know. They are mention their BTech civil, BE civil, so that I can understand, okay, you are applying for this position. Okay, like of course BE civil, so then only you can apply for that. So try to mention your in your resume with your degree, whatever degree you have, which domain you did, always mention your open. Okay, and third thing is not required to mention your strength and weakness. You can say in interview your strength and weakness. So and the third one is very important, is what? Your technical skills. So try to mention your technical skills very well. Very well, what do you mean by very well? You're thinking about this now. So first of all, remember, very well means, suppose you mention there AutoCAD. So what is exact spelling of AutoCAD? A is capital, U is small, T is small, O is small, and C A D is capital. So mention like this, guys. Sometimes they are A U T O, they don't know what is exactly the name of AutoCAD. Means if you are going for Reebok and Reebok, spelling is same, but capital and small difference is also there. So always remember, whatever like is skill you know, mention like that. And then you can see your next software, suppose StatPro. So StatPro is what? Here's TAAD.PRO is small, only RO is small. Okay, so mention like this in your resume. ETAPS, everything is in what? Is in capital. So mention your resume like this order, so that's full good for you. And check your job description. That company want the guy who know the ETAPS very well. So try to mention your ETAPS in add skills, like whatever technical skills you have, in first row in that skills. so that ki company can understand, okay, it's very good in ETS, that's why it's mentioned here. So your maximums are like your possibilities of shortlisting your videos as shortlisting your resume. So ETS first, then AutoCAD, then your secondary software, whatever you know. And sometimes what people are doing, like they just mention their MSCIT and like triple C and some other courses, they just mention MS Office. They don't know about that, but they just add the 5 to 6 technical skills. You know the meaning of 5 to 6? That means you are very intelligent, but in real, you don't know anything about MSCIT. You don't know the full form of MSCIT, triple C and MS Office. Then why mention like this software, man? Just remove these softwares. If you know 2 softwares, that is sufficient. But 2 softwares in deep. Try to know that in deep, that 2 softwares. That is very important. And now, fourth one is what important about your projects. With like project, before project, you can mention their major subjects knowledge. With technical skills, you can just mention their major subjects knowledge. Means what? Means like, suppose you know the major subjects like structure, check their job description. If they are good, like they want the guys who know RCC good, just mention your major subject was RCC. If they want the steel good, you can mention their steel, so that they can ask the question from steel or RCC. And try to prepare also, just not mention their only major steel or concrete. So try to prepare everything about steel and concrete, that is good for you. And if you know the American code and other codes, you can mention them in major technical skills, American code and whatever code you like. Okay, next is about maximum persons are what they are doing, like they just mention their job, like project name only. Project name is not sufficient, man. First of all, you mention your project title and then describe your project. So description in well manners means if I read that, I can understand, okay, what was your projects, so that I can ask you question from that project. Suppose you mention there just one line, cement. What can I ask question from cements? This is not a title, na? Cement test, types of cements, what are the types? Just describe that type so that I can ask question from these persons. Okay, now the next step is what? Whatever your achievements, you can just mention your achievements very well. Okay, and then everyone know your personal details. In personal details, your real hobbies. This is very important. Sometimes just people mention their cooking because they're just going in photo state shop and they are saying them, just give me one for like a sample of resume. And suppose someone mentioned cooking, they know the cooking very well, but you don't know, you just mention cooking. And someone asks how to make tea, you don't know how to make tea, then what is the meaning of that cooking hobby, man? Okay, suppose your hobby is like reading a novels, but you don't know any novel names, then what is the meaning of that novel? So don't mention like this. Your hobby is whatever real hobbies you have, just mention. Suppose your real hobby is playing the cricket, then definitely try to know everything about crickets, how many teams, like how many players are there in your cricket team. So just mention that ball size, about bat and about wicket and whatever is there. My hobby is not cricket, my hobby is reading the novel. So whatever novels, whatever hobbies you have, just mention your hobby. So this was about your resume. The last one is, which is very important for you guys, that is your cover letter. Everyone thinking like, what is cover letter, man? This is the important part. Cover letter, what you are doing right now, you just see the openings, like the this is the HR email ID, just you send there your resume. But that is not sufficient. You know why? Because suppose I'm a structure engineer, everyone is applying, everyone is giving me the daily resume. I'm not going to download that resume and see that resume, what is he like and everything. Man, first of all, mention your cover letter, what I am. And so that, just mention in mail only, so that when I read that, I can understand, okay, he is the people who know the American. Just mention in in your cover letter. I'll give you one sample in a description. You can see that sample. You can see here also, how can we make the cover letter? Means if you know the American code, mention in cover letter. If you know the Indian code, just mention your Indian codes. What are the Indian code? You know IS 800, you know 875, you know every parts of 875, IS 1893. If you know IS 13920, mention these all codes in cover letter, so that if I see your cover letter, okay, this is very impressive. Oh my God, definitely I'm going to download your resume and going to see your resume, because your cover letter was very important. Everyone saying, nah, first impression is last impression. So this is something like that. What? Cover letter is what? First impression. So friends, always make a perfect cover letter. I'll give you one like sample so that you can see that simple. Don't copy that. Just see that cover letter and mention whatever you know, just mention by yourself only. And one more thing, when you make the your cover letter, just see the job description. So try to match job description and your cover letter so that people understand, okay, I want the guys who know these things. Yes, he is the perfect person for that profile, so that he can download that and he can just call you for that. Okay. And one more thing is very important, guys. You just applying on naukri.com and you are waiting, okay, company will going to reward you. It's only in 110% possibilities they are going to call you. You know why? Because you apply for naukri.com, you're not applying for that company. So don't believe in naukri.com, because you know what, they just provide that, whatever, suppose you're applying for any job, okay, they are not going to give all resume to that company. They are just going to give their company, suppose I want to hire the guys, so I can say naukri.com, just send me 1000 resume. So whoever in top just came, naukri.com is going to give their resume only, not your resume, guys. So if you see the openings in naukri.com, just go and check the websites, and in website go to careers, and in careers you can get email IDs. In that email ID with cover letter, you can just send your resume and wait at least 1 month. Everyone is like today applying and they're feeling like, okay, tomorrow I'll get the call. Not possible, man. Because website is not going to access by HR. Website is going to access by a developer. If developer will come, developer is going to give them, yes ma'am, these are the applicants. So you can see that applicants, then only whatever you complete, if you mention that company, so definitely they are going to, okay, openings, okay, this is the relevant openings, cover letter, everything was good, definitely HR is going to call you. So direct go and apply to that company. And suppose they are going to suppose they send you, just come in, so resume, they want people, okay, you can come here in my company and just give your interview. So just go there and whatever requirements, their first requirement is what, at least go with your 4 resume. You know why? Suppose in panel there are 4 members are there, and if you're going with 1 resume, and if you give your 1 resume and 3 persons are waiting, okay, they are waiting, you know, this is the bad impression. If you go with 4 resume, you can just give them 1, 1, 1. They can see, okay, you are good here, because you know if 3 are 3 people are there who they don't have any resume, what they are going to ask? They are going to ask questions. So try to give with yourself, take 3 or 4 resume. So these are the some important guidelines for getting the structure engineering job. Hope you like this. If you like this, please share with your friends so that I can make more videos related to this type of jobs. And if I'll give you the more materials, definitely you can get easily job. So thank you so much for watching this video. Hope you like this, guys.